The following is part four of a four-part series containing footage from the August 9th, 2012 Bloomingburg Village meeting. The footage is presented in chronological order and intended to be watched in sequence.
That they are going to finish the regular meeting, that they're going to schedule a special meeting to allow the presenter to present on a different day. That day is going to be Wednesday, the 22nd. It'll be publicized in the newspaper.
Where's it going to be held?
We don't know yet. We don't have the venue.
Will there be a vote?
We already spoke to some of the people at the fire department. That's not going to be the venue. So we're going to find a spot, and then we'll have notice because it'll be publicized in the newspaper.
Is that August 22nd?
August. No, it will not be on the village website. Publicized in the paper.
Mr. Kelly?
Posted outside on the door.
And nobody
reads. Okay? So you're welcome to sit for the rest of the meeting. They're just going to go over the bills and the regular business. They're not going to have any more public comment because we're going to have the additional meeting on the 22nd.
Have the public comment on this? When can we ask questions of the board? I'm sorry, I missed the public comment.
We're not going to have public comment.
They do not have to.
Let me just state very clearly. You on the one hand want to tell us we can't do the public comment because everybody can't hear it. Right. Then you want to, hold on, let me finish. And then you want to criticize us for agreeing to do it on a different day. I'm telling you.
Everyone is not here.
You misstate the law. That is not.
I'm going to read it to you.
For open meetings and executive sessions, 103D. Public body shall make or cause to be made all reasonable efforts to ensure that meetings, not parts of meetings, meetings
right.
are held in an appropriate facility which can adequately accommodate members of the public who wish to attend such meetings.
That's us.
Right.
This
is the only forum we have.
Thank you.
I made a statement this evening that basically agreed with the sense of the crowd that I got. And the sense of the crowd was that everybody had a right to hear. I have no legal need to be here. I have no legal responsibility to be here. I have no legal responsibility to make a statement. I was asked to make a statement about the development, and I'm more than happy to do it. The whole process has been open from the beginning, and it'll continue to be open. And so when the crowd was getting very, very agitated, saying that enough people couldn't get in, it was very hot, it was not an appropriate venue, I kind of agreed. And because I so believe in the process, and the correctness of the process, I sided essentially with a fairly hostile crowd and said I thought they were right, and the meeting's been adjourned.
The venue evidently wasn't big enough for this evening's meeting, so we decided to adjourn and reschedule for August 22nd, 2012, 7 p.m. Venue to be announced. We're not sure. We're leaning, hopefully, the town park and possibly outside. And, that's all I can say. Thank you, Teddy.
Thank you.
Sue Dloughy, I'm a village resident here in Bloomingburg, and just like the 300 people that are here tonight, we all have a personal interest in what's happening in our village. Me in particular, I live in the trailer park that is located between the new development and the Market Street that was built for the stores that will be built to accommodate these people. In my location, it is obvious that our trailer park will be plowed down, sold at market to these people who are going to develop this land. And therefore, those of us who have lived there for 20 years and raised our families and children in this town will lose our homes. Even though everyone in this town is going to lose a lot of interest, I will lose my home completely. They will close the trailer park and tell us to move the trailers out, and we will have nothing. And the fact that our town allowed this to happen without informing anybody is just beyond any thing I could even believe. I've joined the Rural Community Coalition to try to dissolve this village so that it would become part of the town and maybe to stop these people from ruining our lives. I don't really know what else to say except that this is just beyond belief, and my family will be affected as well as everyone else's, and something needs to be done.